Did ESPN say anything to you about the fact that your doctor was backing you, about the fact that you do have natural immunity?
No. No. And I ultimately requested a religious accommodation. And I think this is an interesting part of the dynamic that I wasn't sure I wanted to share. But so my doctor and my conversation agreed with me, supported me. I have a belief that doctors are people you work with in health. They don't tell you what to do. They suggest what you should do. And they work with you to find the best decisions for your health. I don't think they should be dictators. And I think they give their opinions, right? And you weigh that with your own. So in my conversations with my doctors, I expressed my concerns. He understood them. He supported them. He said, absolutely, whatever you need from a medical exemption support wise, we will do for you. I 100% support, agree with your decision not to get this vaccine. It's a very little benefit for someone like you. And I can't tell you with 100% certainty that this is going to cause absolutely no issues. So he supported me. But what's very interesting is I live in California, and this state has made it very, very difficult for medical professionals to write exemptions for masks or for vaccines. And they put a lot of pressure on our doctors. And when I reached out to follow up with my doctor's assistant to request the information needed for my medical exemption, she said, let me get back to you. We're going to have a meeting as an office and determine how we want to go forward with this, because there are so many women requesting this.
Wow.
And they ultimately decided as a clinic that they would not write any exemptions. I was heartbroken. I'd already started the process of applying for a medical exemption with ESPN, and I was told I would be supported. I brought this up. They said, we're sorry. We just can't, as a company, as a clinic, subject ourselves to the scrutiny that essentially will come with writing these exemptions. So do you see what they're doing to people? They are essentially taking away what they believe is best for you because of the bureaucracy and the pressure that happens when you involve politics in medicine. And this is a really dangerous space to occupy. And it scares me that people are not only supporting this, but encouraging it. Medical decisions need to be for individuals, not for the population en masse.
We just had David Zweig, a journalist who's been doing great work on COVID and the mask mandates and so on yesterday, wrote a great piece in New York Magazine and follow-ups. And he was saying, prior to joining us yesterday, he was on the phone with doctors and respected clinicians and professors and so on. And one of them had said, for God's sake, don't mention my name. And he can get very few of them to go on the record by name with their opposition to these mask mandates. And it's the same when it comes to vaccine mandates too, because of this very reason. They know they're going to be shamed. It's too much pressure. They've just sort of shrugged their shoulders and said, it's better for me if I can stay out of it. But even getting like even the fact that you found a doctor who would write you a medical exemption was progress. You know, I talked with one mom just this week who was telling me she wanted a medical exemption for her son. Her family history is problematic when it comes to the heart and other issues, and she did not want her teenager to be subjected to the vaccine. And the doctor wouldn't do it. And even if the doctor would do it, the school wouldn't accept it because it has to be he has to be diagnosed already with the heart issue. You, as a mom, you know, like you don't have your
That's
baby
insane.
Yet. You can't show your baby to ESPN and say, here are his problems and why I don't want it. Like, you're talking about creating a baby. So your health is all that matters. And if you can't get somebody to write this for you, you're left twisting in the wind. Were you shocked? Have they been kind to you in the past? Did you feel like
Yes.
a valued employee?
Yes, always. I can't say this enough. Like, I really loved my job. It was the dream. It was the goal from the beginning. And I've always enjoyed working for ESPN. They've always purported themselves to be a family. We use that word a lot. When you're on the road with these people, you do become a family. I mean, that is your road family. There are stretches of the year when I would see my play-by-play partner more than my own husband, because you're together so much between basketball and football when they overlap. You do create a family environment on the road, absolutely. And as far as management within ESPN, they've always been receptive to any concerns I've had, supportive. And when I initiated this process of applying for an accommodation. And when I expressed my concerns and my, I guess, reluctance to get this vaccine and what were my options, my reporting manager's response was, I'm sure we can work something out, right? I mean, that's the logical thought. Yes. Of course we can figure something out. Remember, Megyn, I worked college football all last season when there were no vaccines, and I tested and I masked and I wasn't a threat to anyone when no one was vaccinated. So why is it now that anyone that wants the vaccine has it and should be therefore protected? Why am I a threat now? So the logical, I mean, the logical side of me was like, of course we can figure something out for me to continue to go to events and work on the road. That was made very clear once he reached out to people within HR and I guess probably above him, if you will, that there was no exemptions for travel. Like, there was no way I was going to work events or go to games.
That was the first thing that was taken away from you, as I understand.
Yes. So we went forward from there. And the tough thing too is my my contract was up. So I was in contract negotiations as I'm trying to navigate this decision. And that was interesting and difficult at times. So
You're gutsy. I mean, yeah. It's hard to get television jobs and to take on an issue as dicey as this when you're in the middle of a contract negotiation. I mean, it just proves your sincerity to me.
Yeah. I mean, I walked away from the largest contract in my career, and it was contingent on me getting an injection, which I was morally, ethically, and medically opposed to. So when it came down to, I knew I couldn't get it. And when they denied my request for accommodation, I was very surprised because I had hosted for them in the past and I have hosted virtually. So I didn't know why I couldn't continue to host shows virtually without causing an undue burden on the company, but they did not see it that way. And I have to live with that decision.